right, that time again, time for the solo overnight in the woods. And guess what? It's time for another bucket list item. Let's saddle up and get to it. All right, so it's fall time, and we talked about doing a, or possibly doing a do-it-yourself hot tent. Well, today's gonna be experiment number one. We're gonna do it on a small scale, see how it turns out. So that way when it snows and it's dead of winter, we can beef it up and make it badass. So let's get to it. Alright, so if we're looking at this, we have 4 foot by 6 foot. It's going to be cramped in there. I'm 6'1". However, the smaller the area, the easier it is to heat. And along with that, like I said, this is experiment number one. If this goes well, I can beef it up into something larger. I chose a pop-up simply because it's already done. All we got to do is add tarps to our walls. Most importantly, we have this canopy. I can put the tarp underneath it, canopy over it, and that way the water will shed off and down the wall versus going inside. So there's a lot of benefits to this, and the best part is it was on sale for $24, so can't beat that. So as you can see, I'm using multiple tarps here. These are 5x7 tarps. Why? Because I have a lot of them. If you want to use one single tarp to wrap this bad boy, you gotta think about it. 4 foot by 4 foot by 6 foot, you're looking at a 14 footer just for the three walls, and a 20 footer if you want to wrap the entire thing and then cut an opening inside of it. Originally this right here was the back wall, and now looking at this, I'm thinking about spinning this entire thing around, because here's what I can do. I can easily roll this back and secure it so I have an opening, and then when I want to close it and heat that bad boy up, I can simply tuck a tarp inside of it and cover it up. If you like what you see here, please do me a favor. Hit that like and subscribe button, then ring that notification bell. Once you ring that bell, please select all notifications. Then take it a step further, grab your cell phone, download the free YouTube app, and sign in. This will give you push notifications when my new videos drop. And if you tuck this underneath this, or flap, I can raise this up. Y branch have a roll up door or an awning that I can go ahead and close and then heat her up. So yeah, I'm liking that. One more right here, and we'll be in business. It's actually plenty of room in here. I can lay down and I'll be fine. The trick now is going to be the hot stove. I have a stove that I had in my video last year. I'm going to put that bad boy right there. And the problem is going to be piping it. Do I cut a hole in the ceiling and risk water or snow or wind blowing stuff inside? Or do I cut a hole in the side of the tarp and vent it out that way? Either way, I have a stove jack. Just a matter of what do I want to sacrifice? Most likely, I'm probably going to go with the sidewall here on these used tarps because they're cheaper and they can be easily replaced. But These are the things you got to think about. You got to weigh it out. My current mess kit that I'm carrying consists of stainless steel utensils, a broiler rack, cutting board, there's our lid, a plate, all of it's contained within the stainless steel 8-inch skillet from Self Reliance Outfitters. Now at some point in the future, all these items will be sold as a mess kit from Self Reliance Outfitters. Until then, go to my description box, you see Self Reliance Outfitters, my affiliate site, my influencer page, and you can piece these items together and create your own.
As always, all the gear in my videos can be found in two places. One, my Amazon influencer page, and two, my Self Reliance Outfitters influencer page. If you're interested in Corporal's Corner merchandise, that can be found on Teespring. All three links are found inside my description box.
I give you Corporal's bacon French bread pizza. That's what we're talking about right there. Mm. Get you all in a few. That pizza hit the spot, tell you what. First time doing it like that, I'm happy with that. It worked out well. New microphone, you see it right here. I'm trying this bad boy out. Let me know what you think. I'm not entirely convinced. It's a lot of background noise. I played some samples and I can still hear airplanes and wind and things like that. So I highly doubt there's a microphone out there that will take everything out, all the background crap, and just my voice. I've looked. I don't know. They're very expensive. So let me know what you think about the microphone. Guarantee I'm going to end up getting burned out of that bad boy. Tell you what. Looking at this, though, it's exactly what I envisioned, so I'm happy with that. Just surprised that no one's built something like this for the market, that we can buy it. You know, $100, here you go. Supply your own stove or get a stove to come with it. Simple design, man, and it's solid. So, digging that. So, like I said, experiment number one. So, I'll let you know. So damn hot that I burned myself out of here. Had to keep the door open or partially open most of the night. But it's that time, so let's see what this bad boy can do. Finally, a shelter that I can sit up in. Breakfast burritos. Can't go wrong with that. Coffee's different. Maple, bacon. Digging this. Thank you. Catch you all in a few. About the shelter real quick. It's exactly what I envisioned. We have a reflective system on the inside to keep the heat in here. A small pop-up 4x6. Like I said, that's kind of small, but I was actually able to stretch out. So there's some give in the walls and it was perfect. And it's early in the year, that heater or that stove actually was going to burn me out of here. Right now, the heat just pumping off this is just too much. So in the winter time, something like this, a small area will heat up nicely. So for the first experiment, I'm happy with this. Oh, and the Gorilla Tape actually held the stove jack in place and didn't melt. It's perfect. And it's starting to rain a little bit. other one for the books. With that, all the gear in my videos can be found in three places. One on my Amazon influencer page, and two on my Self-Reliance Outfitters influencer page. If you're interested in Corporal's Corner merchandise, that can be found on Teespring. All three links are found inside my description box. Now please do me that favor, hit that like and subscribe button, then ring that notification bell. Once you ring that bell, please select all notifications. As always, thank you for your comments, views, and support. Thanks for watching. Be out in the field, have some fun. I'm going to catch you next time.